guy's in here more than I am.
Yeah.
Jordan Davis.
I have been. I appreciate y'all having me as much as I've been in here.
You do the sports show with us a lot, and you're just part of the group. So it does.
You mean the best podcast ever, 25 Whistles.
Boom. Thank you very much.
Wow.
There you go.
So here's the deal. I know you have something to promote, but we're not actually going to let you promote it unless you get 3 of 5 on the famous Jordan game.
Okay. I should be.
If you get 3 out of 5 in famous Jordans, you can promote your project for 15 seconds. Because then we're going to play the famous Davis game.
Oh, wow. That's tough.
And if he gets 5 of 5, he gets to play a song from it.
Oh.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Exactly.
Just acapella.
Here we go. Jordan Davis is here. But he has nothing to promote yet. He just showed up. We don't know why he's here. Jordan. It's the famous Jordan game. Name the Jordan. A singer known for his 1995 single, This Is How We Do It.
Come on, dude.
Oh.
Don't help him.
I'm not.
You know the song?
This is how we do it. I'm going to say Jordan McKnight.
Jordan McKnight. It sounds like a meal at Burger King. Or
McDonald's.
A McDonald's. Well, BK. Whatever.
So obviously it's not Jordan McKnight.
No. It's not Jordan McKnight. It is actually Montel Jordan.
Montel Jordan. Okay. So
he's setting up now. He's the meme where the video game player goes from sitting up to leaning. Okay.
All right, I thought it was maybe first name. That was my mistake. I'm not worried about it. What next? Here we go.
Singer and member of the boy band New Kids on the Block, who rose to fame in the 80s and the 90s. Famous Jordan.
John Jordan.
John Jordan, wow.
This is not good.
Isn't he the guy? That's my name too.
John Jordan.
Jingleheimer. No, that's John Jacob.
John Jacob.
But the singer from New Kids on the Block is Jordan Knight.
Yes, Jordan Knight.
I was one mick
off. Dude, take that mic off.
I was one mick off.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Man.
Yeah, you were pretty cocky.
Is there a Jordan McKnight? Maybe not.
I'm sure somewhere. You got a phone book in some town.
I just thought there was a singer. All right.
Jordan
Davis, this next one.
We only play his old songs and never promote the project he's here to promote. Yeah. That's what would be hilarious. Jordan sings songs like Buy Dirt. Maybe you heard that one before. Maybe you haven't. You got to get these next 3 in a row, buddy.
I know.
Okay. An American actor known for movies like Creed, Black Panther, and Just Mercy.
Oh, gosh.
Name that famous Jordan. Bruh.
Oh my goodness. Do you watch anything?
No, I do. It's like.
And it's your name.
It's B. Jordan, right? Something B. Jordan.
B. Jordan McKnight.
Don't do that.
Oh my gosh. Fantastic picture.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic picture.
Which one, Creed?
Thanks, Ebert. All right.
I'm Bradley something. Wait. James B. Jordan.
James B. Jordan.
Oh my goodness. I am so
what
impressed.
Is it?
That's Michael B. Jordan.
Michael B. Jordan. Michael Jordan. Dang it.
This is not good.
Maybe we throw him a scrap or something. But
I mean,
he did say B, though. Like,
but he also said he'll do really good at this game. You guys remember that?
Yeah.
Because I thought it was going to be like.
Like what? What did you think?
I thought it was going to be like, who singles you up? Me. I thought it was like a toss-up.
You thought we were going to do a game where you were the answer?
That's what I thought.
Jordan, that would have been dumb.
No, I mean, I was like, who played basketball is number 23?
Name a really dumb Jordan.
Jordan Davis.
That's correct. We got one. Wow. Okay.
This is going awesome. This is going great. All right.
Well, you got one, so you'll get a little sliver.
Okay.
Actor turned director. He started out on Mad TV and had a sketch show on Comedy Central. He's directed movies like Get Out, Us, and Nope.
There's no chance he gets this.
No, I know this one. Jordan Peele.
Correct.
Yeah! Yeah! Let's go.
We got 2. Okay, here's what we're going
to
do.
He just needed to warm up.
I just needed.
Well, we'll give him a chance to know your Davises in a minute.
You just had to call him stupid.
Thank you, Amy. Yeah. I just needed to, you know.
Oh, you like that insult. That's your thing. You like to be insulted so you feel better.
No.
Okay.
Although I knew I was going to get that today, so.
Okay. Well, no, you came in and said, I'll nail this.
That is true. I brought it on myself. You're right.
Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Jordan is here. Now, we're not going to play a new song. We're going to play an old one from him, at least.
Good.
Yeah, we're not promoting anything so far. There's no announcement whatsoever, just another day. But I will let you pick one word from your new album title and say only one word from it.
Tucson.
That's not in your album title.
Oh,
name a Jordan that doesn't know the name of his album.
Bluebird.
Okay.
I had to be Coach.
Oh my goodness.
What are you talking? Are you talking about the album title?
That's what I just said. Did I not say that?
Yeah, you said that.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. He's frazzled. He's frazzled. We're gonna come back. Sorry, buddy. We're good. We're all here. We're having fun.
Let me regroup here.
Yeah, regroup. Jordan
Can
Davis
we start
is
this over?
No. Jordan Davis is here. Somebody Bluebird. Mm-hmm. We'll find out in a minute. But let's play By Dirt. CMA winning. Boom. This is the guy. Jordan Davis, Bobby Bone Show. Back in a second. Okay, he's here. We know something about a Bluebirds, all he told us. But we're promoting something if he can get 3 out of the next 5 on Know Your Famous Davis. Now, we played Know Your Famous Jordan. You didn't do so hot.
Not so hot. Okay. I'm hoping this one goes a little bit better than
Jordan
that.
Jordan Davis is here. Does he know Famous Davises? Here we go. Question number 1. American record producer, 5-time Grammy winner, and he was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a non-performer. From 1967 to 1973, he was the president of Columbia Records, and he signed artists like Bruce Springsteen and Billy Joel. Can you name that Famous Davis?
I cannot.
You are... What? What is...
What? He's joking.
You're being funny now.
No.
If Lunchbox knows this...
Lunchbox, call him stupid, then he'll get it.
No, are you playing stupid Lunchbox or are you really know stupid? It. Clive Davis.
That's right, Clive Davis.
Clive Davis, okay.
How did you know that?
I have no idea. I
don't know who he is, but I've heard of him associated with music.
What if he comes in and he never promotes what he came in for and he just goes home?
This is
going to be the funniest thing I've ever heard.
If I don't get an answer right, it sounds like that's exactly what's going to happen.
So funny. Okay, let's try.
Okay, Clive Davis. Here we go. I do know of Clive Davis.
Oh my God. An NFL Hall of Famer who played running back for the Denver Broncos from 1995 to 2001, Terrell Davis. That is correct.
You knew
that one. Come on.
Hey. That's my 25 whistles coming out of
there. Yeah, that is awesome right there. I'm just going to stay in that lane. I'm going to throw the guy some chum here.
No.
Quarterback for the Houston Texans. He played college football at Stanford and was selected by the Texans in the 3rd round of the 2021 NFL draft.
Davis Mills.
Correct. Look at this guy.
You got Davis Mills.
So he knows sports, but not music.
Clive Davis.
Well, priorities here, Amy.
Okay. Next up, he's best known as the lead vocalist and frontman of the band Korn. He was considered a pioneering act of the new metal genre. Do you know the lead singer of Korn? You can even go to somebody on the show as a lifeline here if you'd like to.
Obviously, Lunch knows everything. So.
Why would you go to Lunchbox?
Oh, there we go.
He might get this, but why would you go to Lunchbox?
I don't know. Korn?
Yeah, Korn.
Hang
lead
on.
Singer
I
of
know.
Korn.
I do know, like...
Davis. Famous Davis.
Mike D, you got anything here?
He knows it. Lunchbox, who is it?
I have no idea.
Go for it.
Okay. Davis McKnight.
Oh, boy.
When in doubt, go McKnight.
Go McKnight. It is Jonathan Davis.
Davis.
Okay, you need this one. Are we just booking for Monday? He comes back.
Come on, Jordan.
After I read up on all famous Jordan and Davis people.
All right, Jordan Davis is here. An actress known for Thelma and Louise. Also, A League of Their Own, the baseball movie.
Linda Davis.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness.
What is wrong with you?
Get him out of here.
What is wrong with you? Why do you hear it out?
Because you went fast to show us how smart you were. The problem would have nailed it fast, we'd have been like,
what's her name?
Gina Davis.
Yeah, you just
Bones?
Oh, my gosh. Well, give it up for...
All right, thanks for coming by.
My aunt's name is Gina.
You know, okay.
Isn't there a Linda in A League of Their Own?
Linda Davis is a different person.
What does Linda Davis do?
She would be in music.
The reason why I said it so fast is because I was dead set that was Linda Davis.
Yeah, we know. We saw. An American trumpeter.
Turns out it wasn't.
An American trumpeter who's among the most influential and acclaimed figures in the history of jazz.
Come on, dude.
Miles Davis?
No. Miles Davis.
Yeah, okay. Well, look, we're going to talk about his album. You know what? We put him through the ringer, so this is what you get as a consolation.
Well, smoke that
one. To talk about.
Here we go.
Nailed it.
Linda Davis is Hillary's mom, Lady A.
Does she love you?
Yes.
Yeah, we get it. You come here, you're nervous. You're around all these big stars in this room.
Yeah. Totally. I knew I was going to.
Yeah.
Okay, Jordan has an album.
Lunchbox is going to call me an idiot.
Uh-huh. It is out today, Jordan. What's the name of the album?
Bluebird Days.
Is it good?
I sure think so. I sure hope it is.
I like that.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, another number one you just had a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
Which I think may be one of my favorite songs from you as far as like super catchy when it comes on. Yeah. Because you have songs that are, like really good and deep and make me go, oh man, that's sweet. But then you have, well, the wind of those feels and it's, that one hits. Like, that's good. Feels,
I definitely feel like we meshed lyrical kind of meaning and definitely up tempo, good feel.
Play a little bit of What My World Spins Around from Jordan, if you don't mind, Ray.
To the way that it feels when you lean in and kiss me, the way that you dance when you get kind of tipsy.
Yeah, I bet it feels good.
I bet it feels good in the set, too, to have another number one.
We start our show with that.
Really?
Yeah. So that's a good one to kind of.
What were you starting on the show with?
A song of mine called Need to Not.
So now you play a song everybody knows to start. That's awesome.
Yeah.
So between, you have five number ones, and then you have Almost Maybes, which I feel like was a number one because everybody knows that. Here the goodness be that one.
Yeah.
Six songs that everybody knows the words to, even if you're just a casual fan.
Yeah.
That's how you know things are going right, that you can play with somebody else and casual fans still know half your list.
Yeah, it definitely makes making the set list easier, which is so, like, I remember being early on and just having to, A, play cover songs, which nobody really likes to do, I feel like. I mean, maybe some people do. I'm not a big fan of playing cover songs. So now, for a 90-minute set, we can spread out our singles every three songs. And at least, like you said, the casual fan or somebody that got drugged to a show is like, oh, I've heard this song before.
Jordan Davis is here. The new album's out. Which track? Because there's 17 tracks. There's a lot.
Yeah.
It's a lot. Which one would make people cry? If you had to pick one that was going to make people cry, which one is it?
Bluebird Days.
Okay, we're going to play a little bit of this here. Here is Bluebird Days from Jordan Davis.
They used to be sunshine and roses. And their heads were way over there. If they do, then they don't, indeed up dancing right through my feet.
In Bluebird Days, what does that mean?
Man, that's a song I wrote about my parents' divorce, actually. You know, just kind of from my perspective. I'd also say it was like the toughest song I had to play, and actually the toughest song I put on this record. But, you know, I think with this album I wanted to be more honest as a songwriter and show growth as not just a songwriter, but also an artist as well. So, you know, I think you got to kind of take some chances and risk putting an iffy song on a record to do that.
New album, Bluebird Days, is out right now. Just to walk through some of Jordan's number ones. 2018, Singles You Up.
If he ever singles you up.
2019, Take It From Me.
Take it from me if you want a t-shirt to sleep in.
2020, Slow Dance in a Parking Lot.
Throw it in park and just slow.
Looks like 2021 was a lean year. No number ones in that year.
Yikes.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Was, ouch. You know, we're coming out of a lot.
That was a tough one.
Buy Dirt. From massive song. And then
2022 was a good one,
It
though.
Was a good one. Big one. And then 2023 had a two-week number one with this one here. Recently happened, What My World Spins Around.
To the way that it feels when you lean in and kiss me. The way that you dance when you get kind.
One of the fun things about this is I was with Jordan, and we saw Ryan Hurd somewhere. And this song had just been announced as his single, and he's like, this is a single. And Jordan and I ride in the same golf cart together, and we see Ryan, and I go, hey, there's Ryan. And he goes, Ryan. They start talking to each other. I'm like, I'm going to record this. This will be a good moment, first time. And Ryan goes, don't record me. Now, why do you think Ryan said that? Because he's a prima donna? No, because he was supposed to be doing something else and he's playing golf.
Now, how awesome would that video have been now?
That's
that,
my
like,
point.
That, was such a, it, that ended up being such a big song.
Yes.
I actually was messaging Ryan about that. I was like, dude, if we could have had Bobby.
I wasn't even going to post it right then. I was just going to save it as a nice moment.
Just,
but he's like, don't record me. I'm supposed to be somewhere else right now.
Don't record me. I canceled a co-write to play golf.
Well, I didn't even say that. That's Jordan. That's Jordan saying. But who knows what date it was?
That's a long time ago.
Could have been any date at all.
Could have been anybody.
Could have been any date at all. So when you put out new music, do you get anxious before it comes out?
I think so.
What song
do you, right now.
What song do you feel the most vulnerable with on this record?
I mean, Bluebird's there. I have a song called Short Fuse on this album that it came from overhearing a conversation with my wife. She was talking to a friend of hers, and I overheard her saying, like, yeah, Jordan's got a real short fuse. And kind of led to a conversation, and I didn't like hearing that. So this is kind of a song to myself about,
it's just him breaking glass. It's all just a song of him kicking in.
But yeah, so that one's pretty spot on.
Here's a clip of Short Fuse.
Finding blessings in the small stuff, a little more finally letting go of things I can't change, a little more style,
running from the rain and a
little more. What are you guys going to do now for as far as your single goes? You got that all laid out?
Yeah. Next thing is going to be a song called Tucson Too Late.
What's the play there? Too soon, too late? Tucson too late?
Tucson too late. Just got to Tucson too late.
Oh, so it literally is the city.
Yeah.
Got it. And you wrote this, obviously, with your brother. Was it the same guys you won the CMA with?
Yeah.
All four, that crew there?
The Jenkins Bros, Jacob, Matt and Josh, yeah.
What was this?
So we had, you know, we've written that group together, me, Jacob, Matt and Josh. We've been writing together since 2016. So we've written a ton of songs. Obviously, we had Buy Dirt together, and I think we showed up after that kind of not knowing really what to do, where to go next in songwriting. And I credit them to being like, hey, man, let's do something different. Like, let's push and write a song that we've never written before. And actually the kind of influence of this song was Keith Whitley's Miami, Miami. Like, I'd never really done a story song and kind of just totally taken myself out of it. So this was my take on kind of my Keith Whitley inspired single.
So you like to play golf?
I do.
Obviously. You ever hit anybody's house with a golf ball or like broken a window or anything?
Yes, I have.
And then
you know that. You know I have.
No, I don't know. I'm just asking. I'm an interviewer here.
No clue.
Yeah, I have no clue here. So what happened? What can you give us more?
So I was playing in Florida on it was Jim Furyk's celebrity golf tournament. We've done them. And we're playing on TPC Sawgrass, not the actual stadium course, but a really nice course right next to it. And I slice one. Never happens. You guys know that.
Yeah.
Never.
Perfect.
You know? And as I pull up to the house that my ball kind of went into, there was a guy standing outside in the backyard with my golf ball and was like, you broke my window. It's a double paned window. It's like, it totals $870. Give me your license.
He tells him that right then.
Wow. Crazy.
Takes my license. I was like,
why would you give him your license?
Because I was kind of like, I mean, I just smashed this guy's window.
But you gave him your license?
Well, he's like,
he asked for my kid, so I handed him over.
Well, he's like, I need to take a photo of your license. And I was like, okay. And he was like, then he asked, he's like, you know, a deposit. He was like asking for like, basically me paying him there. And I was like, hey man, like, you have my address, like send me the bill. Like if that's how this works, I've never been on a golf course where if a golfer breaks a window, especially a nice golf course that the homeowners doesn't pay for it or whatever. I hope this guy listens to the show because I'm actually really frustrated. And I get after the tournament, I get back in and I actually go up to one of Jim's buddies. I was like, hey man, on 16, I busted a guy's window. He's like, ah, man, don't worry about it. You know, I was like, well, I told him I'd pay for it. And he was like, no, dude, the homeowners takes care. Like, they fix all broken windows.
Oh.
And when I got home, there was a bill from the guy that was trying to squander me out of $800.
That's messed up.
He was trying to shake him down for $800.
A nice neighborhood. Like, this guy did, again, hey, I broke your window.
That's probably why
I
got an expensive house. Yeah. He made all that money from $800 a pop.
Yeah,
rolls.
So, yeah, dude, wherever you're at in Ponte Vedra, Florida,
that's
I got your bill, and I'm still not paying it. Still to this day. Take me to court.
All right, we're going to play Jordan's new single from his new album. I hope you check it out. The new album is called Bluebird Days. It's Jordan Davis, a platinum recording artist. Multi-platinum recording artist. Also, go to JordanDavisOfficial.com for all the tour dates. You're all over Europe, March, pretty much most of March. And then he's all over here, Biloxi, in Tennessee. He's doing iHeart Country Festival. I mean, he's all over the place. I'm so happy to see your success. Thanks, congrats buddy. On the record, and I hope people listen to it like crazy.